Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys 8 different makeup hacks that you have never seen before. I'm sure one or the other you may recognize from, I don't know, somewhere. But some of these you should definitely not recognize because I tried really hard to find a lot of unique hacks that you've never seen before. So don't forget to vote for next week's video just by clicking the top right corner, click the little eye, and then just select the video that you would like to see next week. And without further ado, let's get into the video. So here we're squishing in a quick surprise giveaway because Foreo was kind enough to send me one of their Foreo Luna Mini 2s in the color aquamarine for me to give away to you guys. So this giveaway is going to be international and it's going to end next week, so I'm going to be announcing the winner in next week's video, so make sure to go check that out once it's out. All you have to do to enter this giveaway is you have to be subscribed to my channel, like this video, and comment any random comment down below. So I hope you all enter. And let's continue with the video. So this first hack you can use if you have any cream product that you hit pan on and you're having trouble getting the product like out of the corners of the side and you just wish it were leveled out again. So all you need to do is you will need an X-Acto knife and then you can just pop out the pan out of the packaging. Next, you're gonna take some tweezers and you're just gonna hold it over a lighter so that way the product starts to melt and level out again. So if you're a little bit younger, make sure that an adult is supervising you or doing this for you because this can get pretty dangerous. So after mine has melted and leveled out nicely, I put mine outside and let it cool off. And once it has cooled off, I could just pop it back into its packaging. And as you can see, this does not change the formula in any way, so don't worry, it's literally just melted down and leveled out again, but it's the exact same product you had before. So I don't know about you, but it's happened to me before that I got so excited about a brand new lipstick that I twisted it out a little bit too much, and when I used it, it just broke. So all you need to do to fix it is you will need a lighter, and then you will just hold your lipstick over it for a couple of seconds until you see it starting to melt. Then you can take the broken off piece and carefully press it against the lipstick so that way it kind of looks like it did before. And then you can take a wipe and just wipe away the excess around the edge and then you can twist it back into its packaging and it's as good as new. So most of the time, my eyelashes are all droopy and like looking down, but I wish that they would look up in the sky and be all nice and curled. So what I do for this is I take my eyelash curler and I just heat it up with a blow dryer, so that way it's kind of warm, but make sure it's not too hot because you could burn yourself. And then I just curl my lashes as if I normally would, and that way the curl of my lashes stays much longer, kind of like curling your hair. So to be completely honest, this next hack is more of a DIY, but what you're gonna need is a piece of plastic. All I used is this plastic plate, and then I took my hot glue gun and I started to pipe out like some lines and all sorts of designs. So I did some chevron here, and then I tried to do some polka dots too, but that didn't turn out so nicely. But anyway, you're gonna let that cool off, and then you can add some water into your plate. And now if you wanna clean your makeup brushes, you can just dip the brush into the water, swirl it around on a piece of soap, and then rub it against the textured surface on the plastic plate, and this will just clean your brush all nicely. And as you can see, it is all nice and clean and doesn't have any more makeup residue on it. And you don't have to use a plastic plate like I did. I also made another one here with this like piece of pink plastic that I cut off of a binder or something, and this works perfectly fine as well. So sometimes you want to use a makeup product and then you open it and you realize it's a little smelly and probably very old. So if you didn't know already, makeup products do have an expiration date. So on every makeup product you should find this like little pot that says 12M or whatever M. So the M stands for months and that's basically the amount of time that you can use it. So next time you buy a brand new makeup product, make sure to take a little sticker or whatever and write the date that you opened the product and stick that onto the makeup product so that way you will always know when your products expire and you will never have old gunky makeup that you should probably throw away.
So this next hack is for when you're doing your eyeshadow and you're using a really dark eyeshadow, and then you go into a lighter one and it kind of mixes and gets all weird and you don't want it to mix. So just use the dark eyeshadow as you normally would, and then before you dip it into the lighter eyeshadow, take your brush and rub it against a hair donut. And this is basically going to clean off all the excess eyeshadow from before, and then when you use the lighter eyeshadow, it'll stay nice and clean. So when you're packing for wanting to go traveling and you want to pack your beauty blender, don't just throw it into your makeup bag as if you normally would, because it'll probably break. What you can do instead to protect it is you can take one of these plastic Easter eggs that you can probably get at the dollar store around Easter time, and all you're going to do is you're going to take your beauty blender and place it inside, and then you can just close it up, and this is going to protect your beauty blender from being all crinkled and breaking in your makeup bag. So this next hack is also a travel hack for if you want to bring some cream products with you, but you don't want to bring the whole container. So you can take a straw and just pinch the edge together and hold a lighter to it so that it seals shut. And then you can trim it down to the size you'd like. And then you can take any makeup or beauty product and just squeeze some of that into the straw. And then you can seal up the other side as well. And then you can repeat this for like a bunch of different products. And then I also recommend putting on like a little sticker with the name of what's inside on it so you don't get confused. And then you can pack all of these little packets and you will just have the right amount that you need. So here comes a quick bonus hack that I was originally convinced that it would work, but it didn't work out that great, so I didn't include it in the video, but I thought I'd show you anyway. So all you will need for this is some floss and an eyeliner. So what you can do is you can take your eyeliner and rub it against the floss to create this like thin black line, and then you can just take the floss and press it against your eye, and this should create kind of a guideline to do your eyeliner. So after that you can just fill it in and you should have a perfect eyeliner, but again, this did not work out too good for me and it did take a long time, so I guess you can try it out if you want to, but it's not that great.
So that was it for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. I love you all so much, and I will talk to you in my next video. Goodbye!